And can you tell me your combined body weight plus equipment weight?
Let me see here. I weigh... Well, I have 85 pounds of stuff on my body that is 190, so 275. Or two... Yeah, 275.
Okay. The creature, you know, grabs, leaps onto you, one talon in your chest, one talon on your shoulder, and starts flapping its wings, and you feel almost lifted off the ground, and then its claws release, and you kind of tumble down onto your butt. Your chant is actually...
Yes, it's broken.
Maybe, maybe not. Give me a willpower save. A d20 plus your willpower.
Which is 16?
Yes.
28.
Not a problem. You managed to maintain your chant even while...
Get the fuck off of me! I'm too fucking fat for you!
But you're knocked on your butt for the meantime while the creature starts like flapping and trying to break through the canopy. Now it is Ryan's turn.
I will attack. 29.
Who are you shooting at?
The 30.
That's
one.
Actually a 30.
It's a 30.
Yeah, 30, and it clears 16.
Okay, so you hit the guy straight in front of you.
3d8.
There's 16 actually clears by... Wait, clears by 16?
And it's at a minus one.
Yeah, because it's got 14 AC. Yeah, so you clear by 20, and that's maximum damage. So 4d8 plus 4.
Sick.
Bastard.
Plus 5, because the extra damage from...
Yep.
Jeff. Right, 48 plus 5.
28!
Oh, man.
Almost as much as the guy with the sword.
It also fails its save by 1 because of Jeff's spell. That's 2 saving throws that have... They failed because of you.
Chant's fucking awesome, and I'm a really good chanter.
So, yeah. I have to roll for spot and severity?
Yes, give me a d6 for severity and a d10 for location. Alright, no critical effects. But the creature is, you know, you shot it through the neck, pretty much, and it's gaggling and spitting out, like, blue fluids, like, running down its throat, and it seems to be hissing uncontrollably. And the last creature, well, not the last one, but the second to last one of these guys comes running at you from behind, Ryan, and leaps onto your back.
And you're dead.
Shit. Both of its attacks digging deeply into your, or scraping against your metal armor, but not penetrating through to it. And it kind of just lands. It tried to leap on you, didn't get a hold, and just slipped off and is now standing directly behind you. The one in front is spitting at the blinded one, turns and spits blindly. And the shot goes wide, sending acid spitting into this tree right here.
Jesus Christ!
I got that shit out of my face.
All right, Ryan, get your second attack, and then we will go to next round.
I'll do my second attack.
Oh, yes, both of your second attacks.
I'll attack first.
Am I
going to
occur?
27.
27 is a hit. 27 is a crit. It has 1 HP. It doesn't even matter. You wreck it.
It would be
creature dies for you. Yes, so, making a missile attack will incur attack of opportunity.
Right, so can I move a little bit away from this guy and then attack?
It would get an attack of opportunity. The only way to move away from him without taking attack of opportunity is to withdraw, which is a full action.
So, I mean, we used to do this back in the day, but I'm gonna moonwalk. Instead of my second shot, I'll moonwalk half movement. I can do that.
Yeah, but that takes an actual attack. You can't moonwalk retreat as... there's a specific withdraw function in the player's handbook. I'm sorry.
Right, but my character is allowed to take one shot and move half the distance.
Yes, yes. Take a
with
move.
Archery fighting style.
But the withdraw action that prevents you from taking attacks of opportunity as you disengage is in place of an attack. You cannot do it in addition to an attack.
Right. But, okay, so what I'm saying... Okay, archery fighting style. You may move one half your distance and fire a shot.
Yes.
So I want to move half my distance, but I just want to do it walking backwards.
Right, but that... So there is the difference between walking backwards and withdrawing. Let me look up the exact rules so I can preach to you from the DMG.
Well, can I just can I walk backwards as far as you'll let me? I mean,
yes,
I get a half move.
Yeah, but Let me. This is why I want to read from the DMG to you, because it explains the rules better than I can. Here we go. To get out of combat, characters can make a careful withdrawal or they can simply flee. When making a withdrawal, a character carefully backs away from his opponent, who can choose to follow. The character moves up to one-third his normal movement rate. If two characters are fighting a single opponent and one of them decides to withdraw, the remaining character can block the advance of the opponent. This is a useful method for getting a seriously injured man out of combat. Fleeing. To flee from combat, a character simply turns and runs his full movement rate. However, a fleeing character drops his defenses and turns his back to his opponent. The enemy is allowed a free attack or multiple attacks if the creature has several attacks per round at the rear of the fleeing creature. So you can withdraw, but that's like an action. That's instead of attacking this round, you would take the withdraw action. So you've already started firing. You cannot then withdraw from the creature. And when we did it earlier with the moonwalking, I didn't bother explaining that mechanic, but that's more or less how it was operating.
So what? So if I understand this right, you can only walk backwards if you take zero attacks, is what you're saying.
I'm saying you are... We simplify by saying walk backwards, but it's not that. If you walk backwards, he's just going to follow you. You know, you walk, he follow, sort of thing. If you want to escape from being closed quarters with a person, you take the withdrawal action. It's not just walking backwards.
Right, I got you.
Yeah.
Well, I will still walk backwards and let him follow me. That's
okay.
Fine.
So you back up and he chases after you a little bit, to the extent of the movement that he can make that round, which is not that great. Okay. Initiatives, then.
So now this guy gets a back attack. It's better.
Neil, I have a question.
Yes.
So, enlarge, would it affect a ranger in terms of strength? Like, would its shot be harder if he's enlarged?
Enlarge increases the weapon damage of all creatures by the percentage that you enlarge them. By 10% per level.
And it makes it the person more vulnerable. Or no? Like it reduces the AC
say?
Or no?
What does the spell say?
It doesn't say anything.
It doesn't do anything.
I think it just makes the AC go down. Well, where did it say?
It
I don't know. I just think it does. Wouldn't that be great?
It doesn't even say its strength goes higher, but in every campaign
does go higher.
But in every campaign I've seen, it had effects other than just making the person bigger.
Page 173 of the player's handbook.
Maybe I'm missing info in my spell description.
Yeah, because the full description's not on the site, sadly.
Aha!
To get that
read your spell, Jen. But the spell is in there, Neil.
That's a very good argument. Well done.
That's fine.
Magical properties are not increased by the spell. A huge plus one. All equipment worn or carried by the creature is enlarged by the spell. Unwilling victims are entitled to saving throw. A successful saving throw means the spell fails.
So are you telling me that I also have shrink?
You have to memorize either enlarge or shrink.
I would have taken it, but I wasn't sure I had it because I read the spell description and it wasn't there.
Magical properties are not increased by the spell. A huge plus one sword is still plus one. A staff-sized wand is still only capable of its normal functions. A giant potion merely requires the greater fluid intake for its magical properties to take effect. Blah, blah, blah. For example, a fighter at 160% normal size hits with his longsword, rolls a 6 for damage. The adjusted damage roll is 10. That is D6 times 1.6 because you're 106% larger. Blah, blah, blah. Bonuses due to strength, class, and magic are not altered. Yeah, so you just deal more damage depending on the size that you go up.
Okay, I'll cast it on Ryan.
Okay.
What is this?
He won't be able to pick you up anymore.
Jen's enlarging you.
Okay, perfect.
Do you accept the spell as you start growing in size?
Yeah, Ryan, you can refuse it. I don't know if you're listening to that. You can make a save or spell if you don't want it.
No, I know that. I'm cool with being enlarged.
Okay. Jen, you start growing. What level are you, Jen?
7.
You grow 70% your size.
Holy shit!
So, 3.5 inches now? Total?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm glad we rolled for that earlier.
How tall are you now?
I was 6'2", so 70%.
So you're like, you're like 10'7" or something like that.
Yeah, you're close. You're just over 10 feet tall.
Perfect.
10 feet so, tall.
So I can touch the with my hand. Yeah, I can touch the top of the canopy.
The you could dunk on the trees.
You're 10 feet tall, 340.
I got the Dunk Master Marius skin.
Yeah.
10 foot, 340.
Something like that.
Standard. Oh, wait, you haven't been enlarged yet. That's what Leia's going to do on her turn when she rolls initiative.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Sorry. D10 plus one.
This is where Leia dies and she'll never actually get to cast the spell.
Okay. Okay, seven is first. You are enlarged. Whoop, whoop, whoop. And directly after that goes off, the monster, the winged beast with the shiny black hide and the semi-translucent wings that tried to grab Wojtek and couldn't lift him off the ground, spots Leia behind the tree and makes a leap for her with his claws.
I died.
That foreshadowing. I'm on the ball tonight with the ball.
The creature digs its talons into your shoulder for a combined damage of 10.
I'm at 1 HP.
Cool. And it starts lifting you off and flying.
Neil, she weighs 600 pounds. We didn't tell you, but she's a freaking whale, man.
There's no way Leia weighs more than 255 pounds. Well,
believe it or not, she's been hitting the donuts, the pastries. You know, it's been a long trip.
You haven't seen
the
underneath
world.
That robe in months, man. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So you get lifted off, and the creature starts making its way up into the sky with you. The other creature goes after Jasper Rednickel.
Okay.
All these are at minus one, Neil. Remember that. I keep reminding
minus
you.
Minus one. Oh, yeah.
So wait, it beats my... What did I roll? It beats my 9?
Yes, it beats your 9.
Okay. It's going after me? What does that mean?
No. It's your turn. One of them is going after you in initiative.
Oh, I thought she meant like it's going after me as it wants to attack. Okay.
No.
Okay. 27.
You come up to the side of this. I'll even give you flanking on that. Make it a 28. That clear. Is that including Jeff's plus one?
Yes.
Okay. You clear by 14 on him, which is just a double. So 3D. Yeah.
Okay.
3 times multiplier.
16.
The creature passes its save versus death. It's only a penalty of one.
Yep.
So it passes its save versus death. Okay.
I get a back attack? It's facing Marius.
Flank attack.
Okay.
Yeah.
I guess you factored that in for the 28.
No. If that 28 becomes a 29 to hit.
No, it would be 27 plus whatever flank is. Is that plus two?
Oh, yeah, plus one for plus one for flank.
Yeah, so 28.
Okay.
I don't think that changes anything.
No. The creature seeing, this giant, this human with the bow, who then grew a couple feet in size, shifts towards Jasper and
the spell went off?
Yeah,
large went off for the very first. Yeah. Leaps at Jasper gets a penalty of one to hit. It lands one claw on you. The other claw barely scrapes by. This is like the most useful cleric spell that's ever been cast.
Did it? Neil, did you consider it for me?
Yes. You have AC 10 though, so it's really easy to hit you. Jasper, you take 4 damage.
Okay.
As the creature leaps onto you, tries to dig its... It digs... Actually, how much do you weigh? Wait a minute.
How much do I weigh?
It might be able to lift you. You're a dwarf.
He's 130.
I only weigh 130 because I'm 4 feet.
But plus your gear.
Your equipment?
Oh. It says 65, but let me just make sure this is right.
No, you're still too heavy for it to carry with one talon. 40. So it leaps onto you, digs one talon into you, the other slashes against your armor, and it leaps towards the sky, breaking.
Yeah, it's like 66
above the tree, breaking above the canopy.
Wait, so it picks me up?
No. It can't pick you up with just one.
Do I get an attack of opportunity
someone,
as it flies by?
Help, Leo.
No, this is natural attack. Like, it attacks you, pounces on you, and leaps off. Gotcha. Natural attacks don't incur attacks of opportunity. But we do roll initiative.
Next round.
Yes.
Wait,
and the
I
guy
have an
carrying
I have
Leo's.
Oh, no. Yeah, you get a second attack. Or you and a third attack.
I get
first and a second.
I get a first and a second, yes.
I'm so sorry, Ryan.
Help.
No, you're fine.
Leo, hey, she's really fucked.
Is she? How high is she falling from?
It doesn't fucking matter.
She's being lifted into the air. She's not falling yet.
Which one has her? This guy?
The one on, yeah, the one on the left.
Okay, it doesn't matter. I can back attack. All right, I'll back attack this dude.
All right, you have to move to a position where you can actually get a shot on him, which is not, it doesn't affect her.
I can't get one from here? What's this little green thing?
That's just a big bush, but the tree's nearby. You move to a position where you can get an attack, and you shoot at the creature. Roll to hit.
Okay. 18 plus 1,
19. 19, penalty of 4 for the overbrush. The trees, you still hit.
Okay. That's 9 damage with just plus 1.
9 damage, okay. And second shot?
18. Well, minus 2. 16.
Is that with the plus 1?
Yes.
So it'll be 18
minus
2
for the cover. I don't know what the... Oh,
plus 2 for the back attack.
You did calculate the enlarge?
Oh, we didn't calculate the enlarge damage.
Aha!
What do I get?
For the previous damage as well.
70%? 60%?
70% for the last damage too.
70% of
and
what
does
I
the shrubbery still affect him? Because he's really tall, so it might not.
No, it still affects him. You actually did 13 with the first attack. Yeah.
Okay. Is it also to hit?
No, just to damage.
So this next one is 16. Does that hit?
Roll for damage. Yeah, 16's a hit.
Okay.
Roll for damage.
12.
12.
Plus whatever enlarge.
Times 1.7 is 20 damage. Your arrow hits it in the rear and it collapses. It dies. And it and Leia plummet to the earth together.
Calmly reach out a hand and she falls into the
I don't even get like a half action or a movement or anything to try to move.
You took your turn this round already.
Yeah.
Yeah. The creature and Leia are falling together. It is falling on top of her. Leia, give me a dexterity check to try and avoid being crushed to death by this creature. Like, to try and push off of it as you fall. Or grab onto something to try and distance yourself.
I feel like
23.
Hello.
Grab something.
All right. You manage to move far enough away that you won't be completely crushed by the creature, but you're still going to take the falling damage as you fall 20 feet out of the air, taking 8 damage from the fall.
So you're at negative 7?
So I was at 1.
Yeah, you're at minus 7.
So I'm at minus 7.
Leia's unconscious body is laying out on the ground below.
As this happens, as she crashes to the earth, I say, "Great Scott!" And I run over, breaking my chant, and I use my healing proficiency to try to patch her wounds and stop
the bleeding. Let's do that next round, initiative, because there's still one left.
Okay.
The other 11. One's in the air, right?
Yes, it is in the air.
Okay.
And Leia, roll a d10 plus 3 for when you bleed out. Nice.
What do you mean by that?
Are you rolling initiative? Because you take bleeding damage every round. So we'll just roll a d10 plus 3, and whenever that comes up, you take your point of bleeding damage.
Oh, it's initiative.
Yeah. Wojtek, are you rolling initiative?
Yeah. What is to just heal?
To use your healing proficiency would be a d3. Or a 3, a d10 plus 3.
Nice. Nailed it.
All right, Wojtek, you go first. You sprint the distance to Leia, put your hands on her. Pull out your healing gear.
I tear off her robe.
Tear open her robe to get
everything out of the way between her wounds and the healing hands.
Okay.
Also, I'm really handsome, so it's not weird.
Make a healing proficiency check.
God damn it!
Wait, it's d20 plus something, but it doesn't matter.
Oh yeah, but yeah, there's you don't have any.
Well, I need 14 as the clearing number, right?
No, I thought
it'd be
it was
plus 14.
Yeah, so it's 16. Anyways, whatever.
Oh, yeah. And I need over 20 to do it. Okay, I see what it is. Okay. Yeah. So I fail this first time.
Yeah, I'm you just, try and
the robe's getting in the way.
But there's something in the way. You know, you come back, you
goes to you rip go open to the robes, start, and like, instead of just ripping the robes, we just see Leia like pulled in two, and we're like, Wojtek, what the fuck?
I don't know my own strength.
Leia, you take a point of bleeding damage. You're at -8. And I forgot to roll the monster. Okay, the winged beast keeps flying. Marius, it is your turn.
Okay, I am attacking the last guy in the back. It's a back shot, right?
But he has moved pretty far by now. He is at medium range for you. What is your medium
range? Wait, how has he moved if he hasn't taken his turn yet?
He did take his turn. There's no world. I can't move him off the map. I could do.
Gotcha.
What is the medium range of your bow?
Let's see. All I have written down is extreme range. Is there a medium somewhere? Oh, I see. I have four ranges.
Mm-hmm. Medium is the second one.
The second one is 140.
Okay, 140. Yes, he is still within 140 yards, so you can get a medium shot on him.
Okay.
So that's two for medium range and four for the canopy, so make the attack at -6, but then +2 for back attack. So make the attack at -4.
Okay, there's the roll, and then just -4 is 18.
18 is a hit.
Okay. And damage is 2.
Nice.
3 if I'm still affected by Jeff's spell.
No, you're not. I broke the chain.
Okay, 2.
2. Okay.
But you're large.
Oh, yeah. Yes. 70%.
So 3.
I'm the team. Correct. Remember, sir.
All right. And who is next on the initiative order? No, Jasper, you don't go next. The creature turns and starts flying back towards you guys on its turn. Jasper?
Yeah. Marius, keep that fucking bat thing away from us.
Oh,
give it all she's got.
25.
Wow. What is this using?
A heavy crossbow.
Okay, you're at medium range. What's the range
32
of your crossbow?
32 yards.
32 yards?
32 is from the the combat and tactics book. So I don't know what
No, let's use the real one. Heavy crossbow range is 80, 160, 240. So that's at medium range for you, too.
If it took its turn to come back at us, then it's really close, actually. If it's
that's true. It is all the way. It's close enough to be in short range for you, to be honest.
Yeah. What does that mean?
No penalties whatsoever, except for the 4 for the canopy.
So what?
You count the enlarge.
So if that's your actual attack,
then
it's a 21 is a hit.
But a natural 20.
A natural 20, 21 is a hit. It does clear by 5, so a crit.
Okay,
nailed it. These delayed rolls are
13.
Whoa,
13.
And then roll for death if it's not dead.
I will as soon as I can find its HP on my die. There we go.
Save your crossbow is D10. Wow.
Yeah.
Natural one on its saving throw versus death.
There you go.
Also, heavy crossbows do like some crazy shit with the crit table.
Honestly, JP, we should get a leg spasm out of this. So I wouldn't. We should be fine.
What do you mean they do crazy shit with the system?
I thought like the idea behind a crossbow is since it didn't matter about the strength, it was mechanical. So I think they do they do something different with the crit system.
Oh.
I think. Maybe I'm just making that up. Maybe it's just against heavy armored targets or something like that.
Yeah. I don't think that affects critical hits, but since it did roll a 1 on its save versus death, you get to roll as if your weapon was one size larger.
So I'm already rolling, so it's large, so then it's huge?
No. If your heavy crossbow is large, the actual bolt only does medium severity. But since the...
Oh, sorry. My heavy crossbow is medium, so it's large. Okay.
Yeah.
What is that roll? Does it even really matter? But what is it, D8 or 2D6?
Give me just one sec here because I don't... Arrows and bolts fired from bows and crossbows are considered size M weapons. Okay, yeah. So it should be considered size large, which that creature is size large. So roll 2d4 for severity and d10 for location.
Okay. 6.
Nice. Good.
1.
Leg. 6.
Spasm.
Leg injured. Minor bleeding. 2/3 movement when walking.
But no spasms.
I went for the spasm, guys. It's coming. Just wait.
Fingernail falls off. Minor bruising. No effect.
It's so fucking scary. Sometimes the crits are like massive bleeding and you lose a limb. And then other ones are like, yeah, nothing.
Yeah, I mean, if you hit anywhere in like the abdomen, the abdomen, torso, or head, and get like a 5 or higher on severity, it's pretty serious. If you do like limbs, you kind of need in 7 or higher to do anything too interesting.
I love that Alice lost her arm within like 5 minutes of life. Just
yeah.
All right, guys, let's do an adventure. Goddamn, man!
Yep. Okay. Nice job, Jasper. And I think that's initiative round, except for Marius' second attack.
Yes.
Which is now short range, but not point blank range.
Okay.
So just a penalty of 4 for the canopy.
19 minus 4.
Yeah, as a 15 is still a hit. Give me your d8 plus 1.
I'm enlarged. That's 3.
Wow. 3 more damage. Where is that? Okay. Initiative.
What is it to heal again? D10 plus 4, you said? No. 3.
3, right? For healing, unless you're going to cast a 5. Spell.
Yeah, healing. I'm just healing. Finally got the robe off.
Is Leia at minus 9 or minus 10?
No, she's at minus 8. Coming 8. Up on a minus 9.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, Wojtek, you go first.
Old hands, don't fail me now.
You bind her wounds. You prevent her from bleeding out any further. And actually, no, this is the... She fell to the ground. Yeah. She's stopped bleeding.
She's not conscious, though?
No, she's not conscious.
Okay.
And Leia...
I cover her back up, then.
I guess it doesn't matter because it's your turn. You don't bleed out this round, but the large, leathery, shiny, black-winged creature furls its wings and bolts through the canopy straight for you, Jasper. This is considered a charge attack.
Okay. I claim my Morning Star on my shield.
Plus bruising and forgetfulness.
I'm still banging on my shield as it's coming down.
Fuck. Damn it.
The banging
it misses.
Works.
It lands, one claw comes too wide, the other claw slams straight into your shield. I guess it would have been your chest, but you get your shield in the way, and you stumble backwards a few feet from the force of impact, but the creature like bats into you and lands on the ground before
now,
you...
I don't know why I'm doing this, but I did roll for a crossbow attack instead of weapon attack. So would that mean my shield is still not up?
That would be correct. What is your AC without your shield?
17.
17, that actually hits you. Yes.
Don't ever say I don't go by the book.
You take 8 damage from the claw.
All right, I'm at 39.
You don't want to be... Your rate of fire with a heavy crossbow is 1 every other round.
Oh, it's 1 every other round? I didn't know that. It just says I thought it just said my speed was 10.
Well, it's not
10.
A heavy... Or no, it is a heavy, but...
Or is that when the speed is 10, does that mean it's a turn?
No. The speed is just the initiative that you would roll for it.
Oh, well then I guess I wouldn't have that out this round.
Yeah, if you look under rate of fire, it has 1/2 round. So 1 every other round. So it takes a round to fire it, and then it takes a full round to reload because
okay,
it's this giant fucking contraption. Yeah. Okay.
So I don't take that damage then.
Oh, because you would have used a mace or your.
I would have my shield up. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Crossbows just dropped to the ground. Jasper, you're next. Creature is standing before you.
Yeah, I'm just gonna beat
red eyes aglow.
No more bless, right? Or no more
right.
chant?
No.
Do I get a back attack, or do I get high ground or anything like that for it being on the ground?
No. It's taller than you, and it's directly in front of you.
Okay. 13. I think that's a miss.
13 is indeed a miss. The Morning Star slams against its hide, which lands with a dull thud, doing no damage to the creature. As I believe it is Ryan's turn. Marius.
Okay.
You see this creature on the ground.
Is this guy?
27 feet.
Perfect. 23.
Is a hit.
For 12 damage. Got it.
12 damage. Your arrow strikes through the wing, ripping it open and landing in its tail, which was whipping about in the front, behind it. Roll your second attack. Not a single one from you today.
25.
Oh, he's at 2 in damage.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, damage ones don't count. Initiative ones don't count.
Yeah. That's a hit, and that is also a kill. Your second arrow hits it in the chest, and it wavers before the dwarf and collapses to the ground dead.
Is that it? Is that the
That's
fight?
It. They're That's all you guys see for now.
Well, unless anyone wants to make an immediate action, we can take a break.
We can take an break.
All right, cool. Let's take a break and we'll come back and see what happens after the fight. So we'll see you guys in just about 3 to 5 minutes. We'll be right back.